So let's understand now quickly what is venation. Venation is the arrangement of the veins and the veinlets in the lamina, and function of the importance of the venation is for conduction of water and conduction of mineral as well as food. We all know water and minerals would be conducted through xylem and food would be conducted through the phloem. So the vascular tissue passes throughout the lamina, and that arrangement or the pattern developed of the xylem and phloem tissue pipe system is called as venation. Remember, it is more prominent on the undersurface in the dorsiventral leaf. Dorsiventral leaves are called as dicot leaves. Now, there are basically three types of venation possible. The most rare to be found in the flowering plant is the furcate type. Now, furcate means fork. Fork means to divide into two or divide into three. So whenever furcate type of venation is there, it will divide in this manner. So like if this is the main branch or the main vein, then it will divide into two, then further into two. So this is the method a furcate type of venation is visible in the leaf. It is rarely found in the flowering plant, but it is very common in the ferns. One of the example of an angiosperm where furcate type of venation is there is Circeaster. So you can learn this example as an exceptional. Now let's come to the two main types. The two main types of venation are reticulate venation and parallel venation. Now till 9th class you had been learning that dicots carry reticulate venation and monocots carry the parallel venation. But today you are going to learn the exceptions also. So reticulate venation, first of all, reticulum means network. So whenever you see a network, network develops because of the branching. So branching and further branching of the veins will cause a network to be developed. That network in biology is called as reticulum. That's why this type of venation is called as reticulate type of venation. Now remember, monocots do not carry reticulate venation, but there are examples with exception. So there is a plant called Colocasia. It is quite common. Whenever there is a lake, whenever there is a stream or a canal, you will find, even in the villages, if there is a canal, you will always find this plant growing next to the water. So it lives, it thrives very much close to the abundance of water. So Colocasia is an example of monocot, which does not carry parallel venation but carries reticulate. Similarly, Smilax is also an example of the monocot, monocot plant which carries reticulate venation. So now reticulate venation is again of two main types on the basis of the number of the veins. So when we say number of vein, we mean to say number of the main veins. So I have collected some leaf just to show you. Now when you see this leaf, this is the lower surface and this is the upper surface. So when you see this leaf, you can easily see there is one main vein which is traversing the whole length. Throughout the length it is present, and then it will give rise to branches. So when you find one main vein, you call it as unicostate, because costa word stands for the main pipe. So how many main pipes or veins are visible here? We have only one. So when you see only one vein, main vein running throughout the length of the leaf, you call it as unicostate. But now let me put another one for you to distinguish easily. Now let's understand this one. Now in this case, you can easily see that there are branches going out, or if this is not that much clear to you, in this case you can see from this point many veins of different sizes are moving out. You can see in this case also, this is one of the vein, the second vein. So from one point they all start. So whenever you find such type of arrangement, like in the case of the grapevine also, it is called as multicostate. So whenever you find a single vein, single main vein in the leaf, you call it as unicostate, and then branches will develop from there. But when you find more than one main vein, it is called as the multicostate type. Now multicostate again can be of two type. It could be convergent or it could be divergent. Now when they move far from the point, because in the junior classes you have learned about this, what is convergent lens and divergent. When the rays come close to each other, convergent. When the rays go far from a point, far from one point, they are called as divergent. So you can easily see here the veins are moving away from one point. So this is an example of divergent. In the same manner, even in this leaf also, you can see this is the point from where the veins are arising. One vein goes in this manner, second one goes. So they all are going from the same point, they are all going in different direction. Same is in the case of the grapevine also. So whenever you find them moving far from each other, from the main point of origin, it is called as divergent type of multicostate. Now because this arrangement looks like a palm, it is also called as palmate type of venation. Now in the same manner, it is even possible, like in the case of the Sisyphus, the veins, main veins, do not go far from each other, they again converge. So they come close again towards the tip of the leaf, and this arrangement it appears to be like a convergent one. So it is called as palmate or multicostate but convergent type of venation. So I hope this point is clear to you. Now let me quickly go through it. Reticulate venation is found in the dicots. There are some exceptional monocots also with reticulate venation. Now on the basis of the number of the main veins, it would be either called as the pinnate or palmate. Pinnate is also called as unicostate, means single main vein. In this case, many main veins are there. If it is carrying just one vein, this is the only way possible. But if it is a multicostate one, either it would be convergent type or it would be divergent type.